Howdy folks, welcome back to my YouTube channel. I am your host, The Mighty Bjorn, and today for you I have another Arma 3 video, and today is going to feature actually part one of a series of videos. So I've been having this idea brewing since we've started the whole Unsung Liberation stuff to actually try to simulate the best I can the Tet Offensive. Now, while this is just part one of that whole series, which is actually a defense of our forward base Alpha, it could have gone better, but it could have gone worse. Most of the problems that had arisen during this operation what actually had come from the limitations of Arma itself. It was not so much my limitations as a Zeus or as the players in whole, and the general feedback I got from the players that arrived to do this operation actually quite enjoyed it. And I basically shortly after the operation was over, I had started planning other ideas to essentially simulate the best I can with Arma and Unsung the Tet Offensive. So anyway, folks, this is part one, defense of FOB Alpha, part one of the Tet Offensive. Hopefully you enjoy the video, and this actually will be quite long. Understand that the battle itself took nearly an hour to record, and actually said and done, the footage was over an hour and a half. Anyway, folks, let's begin. On the outer edge of the barbed wire, I would set up claymore mines facing out to the jungle. That way their command detonated explosives. So when the VC comes close to us, we can light the explosive. I am going to work on setting up different assets to assist us on the defensive. Also, if you guys want additional 50 cals, you have to, I don't know if you guys can build.
Yes.
We can, but it's gonna take 2 men.
So, yeah, I'll do it. I'll do the 50 cal stuff. You guys work on the mines. So, we're going outside the normal arsenal, and I would say, if you want to, go ahead, empty out your backpack and carry as much explosives as you can carry. And then pretty much we'll go back to the SOP gear setup once we're done setting up the defensive, right? I'm also going to be closing off the entrance, but I'm going to have to wait till you guys are done. I'll just be able to place sandbags. And then once you guys are done, I'm going to place barbed wire in front of the sandbags. And I'm also going to have to block off the entrance down here to the PBR. Y'all ready to do this?
Yes.
Yes, sir.
I don't fucking know.
Well, don't be one of them.
All right, so I will act as basically Sting. You're gonna call the artillery. And basically, okay. I will just act as if I am communicating with command to send in the artillery. So there's going to be a delay of roughly 30 seconds from the moment you call it to the moment I actually place it. You'll be able to call smoke, illumination, and HE.
Roger. Can I call out, like...
There'll be no airstrikes.
Five locations for the artillery and say, okay, I want flares all around it, for example?
How will I do it? I'll treat it as there's 4 cannons. So basically, right, you can call one location at a time. All 4 cannons will fire at that location.
All right. Sounds to me. Battle buddies.
Yes, battle buddies. I'm going Saying to smoke you know what is... we actually start this, by the way.
Can we have twos and stuff and turn on the lights? Oh, no.
Yeah. Oh,
I'm having 20 FPS already.
Yeah.
Good news is it's dark, so you can't see it.
Yeah, I can't see my frames dropping. That's right. Why is it so light? Oh, flare. Explains a lot. Oh, I don't like that. I don't like that sound.
Man down.
I'm a Chinook.
All right. Command, give me a hotel echo on red dot.
Man, 200 meters.
Motherfuck.
I'm gonna replace the red dot. Yeah.
Why? Okay, I'm gonna take my load out burning VC children. I will smell some napalm.
Oh shit. You used a red dot. I can't see your dot. Oh wait, never mind. I see it. Okay. Sorry.
This is fucking cursed. See you later, alligator or something. I don't fucking know. I don't live in where alligators live.
My game is dying, and I'm dying like my game.
I don't know, an Allah Akbar or something.
I'm hit.
What the fuck is this guy doing?
Wait a second, Bill.
What the fuck are you doing? Why are these guys just sitting down at the fucking MGs?
How's that?
I don't know. Oh, because they're dead, probably.
Yeah, well, I can't use the MG.
Ouch. I'm dead.
Ouch.
I'm dead. Too dead, bro. Man, 200 meters left.
We all be dying.
Oh, potato, potato.
Burning VC, children.
Alright. Is artillery available?
Yes.
Give me some more hotel echo on red marker. Give me all the hotel echo you got.
I can't fucking see shit. The fuck is...
Right, thank you. Right, another one. Hotel Echo, red marker.
Fuck is this? The fuck's this bullshit?
I want to bribe you. All right, next one, illumination again, red marker.
How the fuck did I just die?
Well, there's a lot of NVA down there.
Afterwards, next firing order, hold to the echo red marker. Fire when ready.
And down behind you should be staying.
Oh, right.
Got him, I got him.
Right, okay. I don't know if you can get me.
Off you go.
Thank you.
Own fucking base.
Marker illumination.
Somebody ran into a claymore. If you want to show someone what armor is all about, show him this clusterfuck.
Absolutely.
Yeet, spicy air and hot air. All in fucking one. Take that.
Just ask the question, is this very, very, like, annoying to set up?
How's that?
Is this annoying to set up, or is this, well, not that bad?
It's not that bad. Oh, I hit the wrong button and ended up in a menu I didn't want.
Hey, because, not gonna lie, this is fucking fun. We should do this. We should do this again.
Yeah, well.
What the fuck is this? It's the beast. There's a vehicle too.
Does somebody have an MG class or anything like?
I can hear you.
Dang.
What?
Hast du irgendwie eine MG Klasse oder so?
Oh, nice! I saw that, Bill. Fucking nice, dude. Dude, you did it. He's like, there's a fucking takeover here. And then shortly afterwards, I hear BOOM! It's like, that was a fucking tank, wasn't it? All three tanks are out. I spawned three tanks and they're all out already. These goddamn gooks, they don't stand a fucking chance.
Damn, it's gonna force respawn. I'm gonna put in some spicy.
I don't know, fucking fire in the hole or something. Ouch. Loadout burning DC children has been successfully loaded. Good to know.
God damn the single digit frames.
Oh, fucking God. Hell. I think this is the lowest on FPS I've ever had in Armor 3.
That says a fucking boss. But it's also the most fun I've ever had in Armor, probably. One of the most fun experience. For sure.
Dude, I'm just spraying bullets everywhere for the cow. Whatever happens, happens.
Oh, I've still got my trusty RPG now.
No, we do it a moment. You know what they would do at a moment like this? Get in the talk and start calling artillery directly on this position.
Dang, you know what to do.
Alright. No. We're not gonna do that.
We're not bitches.
No. We're not, we're gonna die anyway, we're gonna fight. Alright, thank you, Jason.
Who just... an Apache?
Now we're gonna get a B-52 on our location.
Let's drop a Tsar bomb on our asses.
Come on, trench gun, don't fail me now. I'm gonna try to get that 50 cal.
But our mines are working pretty efficiently, aren't they?
Yeah.
Fucking hell, this is fun. You can't see shit in this mess. Oh, fuck!
Get fucked, Goop!
What the fuck? What was that?
I don't know.
Some motherfucker just shot in our own base with an RPG. Well, guess I'm taking the fucking M2.
No, what a prophet.
Vietnam war things.
Yes, casual war crimes.
Go smell some napalm.
I mean, I'm launching my RPG AG frag warheads directly at people.
Yeah, just like in the...
simulations.
Yeah.
Ouch.
Oh, holy shit!
Oh, I think I'm stuck again.
And somebody okay, I can perform first aid. Oh, it's myself.
Alright, thank you.
Why the fuck is this bunker speaking VC to me?
With some napalm.
There was literally a gook hiding in one of our fucking bunkers. I just killed his ass with my 45.
Yeah, just let me die. I'm just gonna respawn with an RPG.
What the hell is happening?
It must be a traumatic experience.
All right, folks, that's the end of the footage right there. Now, there's a lot of different stuff I do want to talk about before I end the video here. Just bear with me for a few moments. First thing I want to start with is doing a defensive mission on Arma is not really a great idea. The problem with the AI is they won't really charge a position as much as they'll advance. And then once they start getting engaged or see a way to engage, they will take cover and they will completely stop what they are doing and engage you from that position. They won't keep advancing. They won't charge. In that situation there that we were playing, the enemy would have definitely charged and overswarmed the base. The next problem also with Arma and the AI is stuff like mortars and artillery doesn't work well for the AI. Mostly because with the stock Arma assets, understand that we don't have the mods for Arma AI artillery. They will only engage when they have a direct line of sight, which kind of null and voids the point of having a mortar, an artillery cannon, etc. That being said, I essentially put myself to some mental limitations on A, how much I would use the mortars for the enemy team, B, I would only use the 82mm mortars, C, I would give some type of warning, which the guys actually did not catch on to the warning. I figured they would have after the first strike, because essentially what I'd do is I'd launch a single flare right over the fob, and then I would launch four rounds of mortar fire. And pretty much it was kind of one of those, I'll only do it when the enemy is a safe distance away from the base. I want to do it just to break the backs, destroy defenses, things of that nature so that they can swarm the base, which later actually I would find out In fact, it would not destroy the barbed wire around the base for some odd reason. I am not sure why. Actually, I was even anticipating that the mortars would destroy the towers, and they actually didn't even destroy the towers. That being said, it still did destroy some of our emplacement weapons, as well as killed some of our bots that we had placed to help with the defensive. The next thing I do want to say as limitations when it comes to Arma's optimization is not world renowned. It's a lot of people say it's shit. It could be better, don't get me wrong, but consider that you're playing on like 20 kilometer by 20 kilometer maps. You have whole enemy forces, you have allied teams, etc. Yes, while the optimization could be improved, they did a fairly good job. But as a mental note, something I personally learned from this experience is next time use less assets, but spawn assets more often. That being said, there was concerns, mental concerns of, you know, is there going to be enough enemies to keep this entertaining, things of that nature. And to also, I was trying to put the point across of how many enemies you would actually be dealing with during a base assault, which is actually quite a few. They would use many troops. I also did want to throw some vehicles in there because mostly this was actually inspired by the siege of Longueuil. I think it's Longueuil, which was a SOG base that was south of Quezon and was attacked during the siege of Quezon during the Tet Offensive. And actually, it was attacked by enemy tanks. It would be one of the first battles where American troops would actually see the NVA using tanks in battle. Understand that, one, Vietnam is not a very good country for tanks. Two, well, the NVA didn't have a lot of tanks. That being said, they did have tanks, and they actually employed tanks like the Type 63 tank, as well as the PT-76. And going by what survivors of the Longueuil battle would say, or what it would seem like they were saying, is that they believe they were attacked by Russian tanks. They believe they were PT-76 tanks. And actually, the photograph you see here is partially an inspiration of the Battle of Longueuil, because actually, if you look in the upper right-hand corner, that is the talk that was there, as well as the observation tower that was there, which would actually be destroyed during the siege. And actually, the Special Forces soldiers that were there, the Green Berets that were there, actually held out against, they're estimating, an enemy armored division overnight. And a few of them would actually get away with, unfortunately, some of the U.S. soldiers dying, as well as some of the Arvin soldiers that had helped them defend the place. There's actually a pretty good documentary where the soldiers that were actually there during the battle talk about it for a little bit. So anyway, folks, this is my part one of the Tet Offensive. There will be more videos dealing with how we dealt with the Tet Offensive in game. Anyway, folks, hopefully you enjoyed it very much. Thank you for watching, and have yourself a wonderful day.